Hi, and welcome to this episode of The Language Lady. I'm your host, Dr. Hemphill, and today we're going to be talking about ways in which you can differentiate instruction for your ELLs. Last week, I took you through the process of what to do when you get a new student and determine what their language proficiency level and then what they're able to do based on that language proficiency level. Today we're taking it a step further to determine now, what do I do? Now that I know what they're able to do, how do I maximize my instruction and how do I differentiate it for the various language levels in my classroom? If you did not get a chance to see last week's episode, I'm going to post it somewhere around here so that you can see it before you watch this video, because the information I'm going to give you today may not make a lot of sense if you don't have that background information. But today we're going to use the same scenario. We're going to use Paola again. She's a third grade student from Brazil who just came into our classroom. And what I'm going to do is provide for you some examples of activities that you can use as a way to differentiate for her specific language needs in listening, speaking, reading, and writing. We're not going to change the content for her. We're just going to change her access to the content so that she can show you what she's able to do.
So to recap from last week's scenario, we met Paola, who's from Brazil. She speaks Portuguese, and she just newly arrived in our country, and after being given the WAFT, the test, she came out as being level one.
So let's say, for example, that you know that next week you're going to be teaching a third grade lesson on fractions. I'm going to take you through the steps as to what you're going to do with the information on Paola based on her language proficiency level and what we know about her in her listening, speaking, reading, and writing scores, and be able to create a lesson that will help meet her needs in this specific area of math and fractions.
The important question you want to ask yourself first is, what is the content academic standard that I will be teaching? Because all your students need to be exposed to the same standard. And also, what do I expect all of my students to be able to do?
These are important questions to ask yourself, because every student in your class should be held to the same high expectations and be exposed to the same content standards. So just because Paola is an ELL student doesn't mean that she is not able to learn at a higher level and not be able to be exposed to the same content standards. So really, really important that you ask yourself these questions for your entire class.
In this sample scenario, I'm going to teach my students how to compare fractions that have unlike denominators. I also know that I'm going to be using manipulatives, I'm going to be using word problems, and I'm going to have them work in partners.
Okay, now that I've put my lesson together and I have a rough idea of what resources I'm going to be utilizing for the general population in my class, now I'm going to go to my WIDA overlay standards to determine what Paola is going to be able to do for that specific content area. And then now I'm going to start gathering more resources and graphics and support or whatever it is that she will need that meets that particular proficiency level that she is at, which we know Paola is a level one.
So this chart just gives me an overall look at what the language proficiency level can do's from one through bridging is going to look like for a third grade student learning fractions.
Okay, so now we have the overall picture, but now what do we do specifically for Paola in this situation? What is she going to do in listening, speaking, reading, and writing? So in order to not make this video too long, I'm going to just specifically look at writing. How are we going to differentiate instruction for Paola in the area of writing of math?
So remember, for every topic and content area, there is a sheet that looks like this. This one's specifically for writing, specifically for math. So this tells me that at an entering level, level one, she can label fractional parts of diagrams. This tells me that there's other language functions I can have her do. For entering, I can have her produce icons, symbols, words, phrases to convey messages. She can draw in a response and she can label. And then here are some extra ideas. There's other language functions I can use, like produce icons, symbols, words, phrases to convey messages, draw in response, a prompt, label, etc. But if I want more ideas for more language functions and more support, I can go to another content area like social studies, look at the entering, and I can steal more ideas from there.
So let's say that in this particular lesson, you want to do word problems with your students. And what you want them to do is look at fractions with unlike denominators. So let's look at an example of this problem.
So for all my students, I'm going to expose them to the same word problem. I'm going to read this to them, and I'm going to point out some of the vocabulary words, and I'm even going to draw a picture to demonstrate what this word problem means. But then when I break up my class into separate groups, Paola is going to get this. This is the exact same problem of the Frank and Michael problem, except now she's seen a pictorial representation, and she's going to label it, telling me which one ate more. The point here is that I'm not dumbing down the information. I'm giving her access to exact same content as the rest of the class, just at her level.
With all of this said, even though I know Paola is a language level 1, there are times where I'm going to want to expose her to some of the language functions and supports that are at the next level. So she's a level 1, I want to think about level 2. Since she's a level 1 in listening, speaking, reading, and writing, then I know that I can think about level 2 for those domain areas. I always want to be thinking about the next step in mind so that they are exposed to something else. Lastly, let me know if you like this video, if you want more videos like this, if this is helpful, if you want me to go more into detail with one of the other areas like speaking and listening and reading. As always, please subscribe. Comment and like below what you thought, and I'll see you next time. Thank you so much for coming by this week.